Good morning, good morning, good morning.
We're running down.
Another lovely day. Oh, when it's wet, it's fine at Butlins. We never let it spoil your holiday. Good morning, good morning, good morning. There's a good time on the way. For wet or fine, the sun will always shine on your Butlins holiday. Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Well, good morning to you all. You alright, sir? You alright? Yes, okay. Welcome to this morning. It's a lovely weather. It's held off. Lovely and sunny yesterday. Thank you for everybody for turning up today. It means a lot to us all. So, I'd like to start off proceedings, and I'd like to introduce you to a gentleman that's played a great hand in this, and his name is Stuart Kingsley Innes. A round of applause, please. Thank you.
Thank you. This all started about 10 years ago when every May I used to have a recurring dream, it's time to go back to Butlins. Unfortunately, I'd been left for nearly 30 years. So one New Year's Eve, I decided to lay the ghost and drive over here and have a look what was left. And sadly, there was nothing left. It was just a pile of rubble. The buildings had come down. The fence was there. And in my hungover state, I decided something should be done about it. What to do? The only thing was a memorial of some kind. I thought about it, talked to people, and we got started. So I'm going to mention a couple of names who helped along the way and made it all possible. First of all, an old Butlins friend of mine, Dave Colwell. We got together and over lunches and things, we decided it'd be a great idea to put a plaque on the island. How to do it? He then approached a friend of his who was with the council, Councillor Burton, and he put the thing to the council, and we attended meetings and committees and things like that. And at that point, the snowball started rolling. We were not only overwhelmed, we were humbled by the response we got from the Vale of Glamorgan Council. They were exceptionally thoughtful, exceptionally kind, and they didn't just say what a good idea. They put themselves out to provide us with what I consider a fitting home for this plaque. So I think they deserve a special mention. A lot of people have helped, supported, backed us. All my friends, the Reds here, campers. They've all got on board, and all over the country today there are Redcoats and Butlins staff and so on and so forth who are watching what we're doing and looking forward to seeing the outcome of today. But I got one very special letter the other week which I would like to read out to you. Dear Stuart, my name is Karen Spence and I am Lady Butlins' personal assistant. She has asked me to contact you and thank you very much for your letter informing her of your plans. She's delighted with the planned Butlins Memorial, and although she is too frail to travel to the unveiling, she will be with you in spirit. As an ex-redcoat herself, she understands your affections for these good old days and would like you to read out the following statement. I am delighted that you were gathered today to unveil a Butlins memorial and have a redeveloped seafront walk attraction in Barry. Although the camp in Barry was the last Butlins to be built and was the smallest, my husband had the greatest affection for it. Indeed, following a childhood holiday, Barry Island became his inspiration for the whole business. He would be very proud that you're honouring him and his camp in this way. I hope you have a lovely day and all goes well. Kind regards, Sheila, Lady Butlin, Jersey. I don't think there's much left I can say, so I'm going to hand you back now to the guy I call the Chief Red, a very good friend of mine, and he will take over for now. This is Mr. Tony Collier.
Right, thank you, Stuart. That was a great letter. I'm sure you'll all agree. A few little things that, before we carry on, is the red coats you see around here today, they've all worked there for numbers of years. And we're talking like 35 years ago. We've actually got one gentleman who is definitely the oldest living red coat to date. He started in 1947. We love him dearly. He's a Barry lad now. He's been here all his life with his wife Tina. He's 90 years old this year, and I'm hoping he's going to come to our celebrations next year at his 91st birthday. And I think that deserves a nice round of applause. And that's only because this gentleman, he's not only been an entertainment manager, he's entertained thousands and thousands of people. He in his day, he was a fantastic comedian. He was a great sort of compere. But everything you can say that we know, and we are youngsters compared to David, everything we know about the stage, I would say is a thank you to you. Because you've taught us stage discipline. You taught us everything else that we need to know in this industry. Thank you very much. And basically, you've got to look at Butlins and think, well, what was it? It was a place where people came together, and not just to entertain thousands and thousands of people, but we became a family, a very special family, and we are still that family today. You know, once a month, we all meet up and have coffee mornings. You know, we take time out from our careers and our different jobs. There's people who travel, as this young man here today, from Carlisle, and that was a special treat because I told him yesterday he wasn't to come. He lied to me and said he wasn't coming, and all the time he was driving a car and ended up last year at Bapa's Four this morning in this lady's house, who runs a business, and was absolutely shattered this morning. I went to find him on the doorstep. And there's other people like that young gentleman up there, Gareth. He used to be the beach inspector at Barry here for a number of years. And so I see a lot of faces. So thanks, everybody, for coming. But I'd also like to ask, to invite a young lady, her name's Elizabeth Walsh, who wrote a lovely poem about her life and about Barry Butlins. Ladies and gentlemen, Elizabeth Walsh.
Times have changed. I need the specs now, I'm afraid. Thank you very much, Tony. Okay, here's a little poem what I wrote, and I'm sure everyone here will agree with everything that I've written. Thank you. Ode to Barry Island. There's not a single day goes by when I don't stop and wonder why. Why did they let it rot away, decaying slowly day by day? It was my little piece of heaven, Butlins, Barry Island, in 77. We wore our red coats with such pride. It made us feel so good inside. We sang our hearts out in the shows. We loved it when we took our bows. There was lovely legs and knobbly knees, kids' fancy dress and holiday princess, the compere, Dave Simpson, one of the world's best blokes, and Brian Ward with all his jokes. Off to the theatre to watch a play, or to the bar for a great cabaret. There was Taffy Apple in the pig. That was such a brilliant gig. Looking back on reflection, we think of Barry with great affection. The memories will stay with us forever. The place brought so many friends together. Some are gathered here today to say thank you, Sir Billy, in this special way. The camp may have gone, but Sir Billy lives on in the hearts of those who pass through the door, the redcoats, the chalymaids, and many more. The campers who flock back year after year, always full of great cheer, by car, by train, by coach, by bus. Thank you, Sir Billy, from all of us. So in your honour, this plaque we set to remind the world, lest they forget. Thank you very much, Tony.
That's fantastic. I'm sure everybody that was very well done, wasn't it? It's lovely. You know, all very meaningful to everybody here today, and will be for the rest of our lives. We will continue to come here, we will continue to wear our red coats year after year, and we will always continue to support and look at Barry as the place to be. You know, this goes past any other function I've known that any other red coat has done, and with the help of everybody here, and Dot, and anybody else, this is going to continue for a number of years. This garden is going to be here, hopefully for 100 years, with that plaque in place. And it'll be a pleasure for me to come with my families, their families, and say, well, I know who worked there, I know him, I know him, I know her. And their families will grow up saying, that was my grandfather, that was my grandmother, and a part of that. So it's history in the making, and it's history we are part to be very proud of, and it's a thank you to all the people of Barry for everything they've done for us to become the families we are with Butlins. Thank you very much indeed. And now it's the special time to come. I'm going to ask the Mayor and Mayoress to say a few words. Thank you very much.
You haven't been worried there for a minute. They're all ready. At least someone else got it very ready. Anyway, sincerely, good afternoon to you all. It does give me great pleasure to be here today to unveil the plaque which was put on this site to commemorate the Butlins holiday camp, which was here in 1986. Right through till, it was here in 1966. Thank you. One of those days. It's been 1966 right through till 1986. I think we need to bear in mind that today's generation awareness of Barry Island is purely because of Gavin and Tacey. But there is an older generation who are aware of the island because of the Butlins holiday camp. And Butlins camp gave ordinary people the opportunity to have an affordable holiday, and these holidays would be made even more memorable thanks to the army of redcoats who helped to ensure that the family's memories were good ones. The redcoats provide family fun activities all day and night and work tirelessly to ensure your time on the camp was enjoyable and you left with many fond memories. I think they are a rare breed, and I can't think of a modern day equivalent that would bring such enjoyment to so many people's lives. Valley Island, with its sandy beach and its coastal link walls, is a great place, and we must thank Sir Billy Butlins for coming up with the idea of a holiday camp on this location and for giving so many people the opportunity to visit for a holiday and have such a memorable time. I'll get this right this time. The Butlins camp was here from 1966 to 1986. Yes, it was merely 20 years, but such is the history and the reputation of Butlins that we will think of it as being here forever.
I knew I should put this on a bigger sheet.
We have redcoats with us today, and I think we should say a big thank you to them for the part they played in the history of this town. sincere thank you to all those redcoats and also the army of workers who helped to make your holiday enjoyable. And now, it gives me great pleasure to unveil the Butlins commemorative plaque so that we will always remember that there was a Butlin holiday site on Barry Island. Right, I've officially unveiled this plaque, and what a beautiful Butlin plaque.
No, that's fine.
Lovely. Here we are. So now it's open for everyone to have their pictures taken after. We are coming to a little close, but before we do that, I'd like Kelly, if you'd like to go and see Augie for a second, please. And if you could have a nice round of applause for the mayoress. And just to close proceedings here at the plaque, remember this is open for everybody and anybody to see at any time. Please bring your families and explain to them what it's all about, because it is a part of history we're very proud of. Thank you all for attending this afternoon. Councillor Jeff Evans, thank you very much for coming, sir. Very kind. Mayor, Mayor, thank you. And all the other dignitaries, and a special thank you as well to my Redcoat friends, especially those who've travelled, you know, many, many miles to come today. And I should admit, it is a long way to come if you live in Carlow. No, I didn't know you was coming, you're right. But let's look forward to next year now. We're going to do a celebration of the plaque next year, where there's going to be, hopefully, 200 people, we think, hopefully.
Well, I think after this, probably, we're normally 120, 150.
So. There we are. So it's about 120, but we're going to strive to get 200 next year. Jim, you'll be back from Thailand, I hope. Join you with us. Next April, that's good. So there's lots of people that lives all over the world that's come. So we would appreciate any support that you have. And ladies and gentlemen here today, you're all very welcome to come back next year and be part of the dignitaries once again. Carol, thank you very much. Without this young lady, we would be dead in the water. So thank you very much indeed, Carol. Absolutely. And it just leaves me to say, Stuart, that thank you to Stuart as well. Have a lovely day. Take pride and pleasure in what you've seen and taken part in today, as I will for the rest of my life. Have a lovely day. Have a safe journey when you go home. For those people hanging around for Barry today, this evening, we've got some entertainment going on in the Commons Club with Lizzie, who's going to be doing some singing, and everybody else can come along and sing. I'm sure Jeff Evans, I hear, has a very good voice. Yes, and of course, straight away after this, if you'd like to make your way down to Marco's Caff, I believe there's some refreshments being laid on, and it'd be nice to have a chat to you all individually. Thank you all for your time this afternoon, and once again, could you all give yourselves a nice round of applause? Thank you. Thank you.
We're going to freedom land. Step into a dream, into a world. inside your happy place. Their magic fingers
will serve us all. There's one man who has unveiled all plaque for us, he's supported us, he's backed us, him and his office and the rest of the council. He's the titular head of the council, and he's also turned out to be a good mate, and he rides a motorbike, so he must be a solid man. So on behalf of everybody, we'd like to present this to Council Howard Hamilton, a copy of Savini's Life Story, the first edition copy. Wow. Secondly, everybody's supported us, everybody's backed us, everybody's given us moral support, but I could not have done anything without the help of one man. He's run around, he's transported me from hospital and back. Anything that we needed, we got. And I'd like to thank my very close friend and bunkmate, Tony Collier. Yeah. Thing. I'm going to ask Tony to do something very, very special, and I'm sure you'll join with him. So Tony, would you do the honours?
One person there I haven't thanked is Carol here, who is the Mayor's Secretary. We've all met Carol today. I won't go into yesterday's and modesty sort of thing happens. So it's all down to the bad wind in Jackson Bay that comes around there. You can guess the rest yourself. But Carol, we couldn't have done anything and everything without you. Please, I'd like to thank Marco for today.